The station coming, the whiskey station coming back. Come back with your call sign again, phonetically.
So Whiskey Alpha 3, Golf Papa Echo. Whiskey Alpha 3, Golf Papa Echo.
Roger, Roger. Copied you good that last time. And the conditions are kind of up and down today for some reason, you know, and they're really wide excursions, like 10, 15, almost 20 dB at times. It'll fade up and down. So don't know. We're trying to do our best. The name here is Jim, Juliet, India, Mike, and the call again is Kilo, Charlie, 9, Victor, Kilo, Victor. Roger?
You okay, Jim?
Yeah, very good.
You're about an S, you're S9 sometimes 5 over. I got the preamp on in the radio. And yeah, you're right, the band conditions have been really, really lousy. 40's been not all that great for some time. So, I guess that's something we just have to deal with here. But I mean, you're coming fine, no problem. Q5, good signal. Good strong signal. I don't really hear anything, any stronger signals actually. The name here is Glenn. Golf, Lima, Echo, November, November. Glenn is the name here. And I'm located in Altoona, Pennsylvania. Altoona, Pennsylvania, about the south central part of the state. Well, I was planning on going up on 20 meters. That's pretty much the band I work most of the time, and it was very, very poor. Heard a few stations up there just on the wire antenna. I didn't put the beam on, but I could just tell that the propagation wasn't all that great on 20, so I thought I'd come down here on 40. Don't hear too many stations on 80, so yeah, it's been pretty bad, really, there, Jim. I heard you calling CQ earlier, and I didn't have the station fired up at the time, and it was nice to hear someone else calling CQ for a change. I used to get in here and call CQ, but contacts are few and far between, so it was nice to hear somebody else calling CQ there. So again, you're coming in very good here, Jim. I'm not having any problems, really. It's nice copy there, Jim. I wonder where you're located there. KC9VKVWA3GPE.
Roger, Glenn. We are located near Louisville, Kentucky. We're on the Indiana side of the mighty Ohio, right at Louisville. And we're doing right now just about a kilowatt from SV220 being driven by older Yaesu 990. And we're just talking about that dipole antenna. It's an inverted V, but with my tuning method, I start on the negative side. I'm just running a choke, and I start on the negative side making my SWR adjustments, and the high side making my bringing it back on frequency adjustments, and back and forth and back and forth till we end up with a 1.01 to 1 on frequency. And so then somebody said, well, it sounds like a Wyndham. And I don't know Wyndham from Slindum, you know, but I looked it up, and near as I could figure, it was maybe pretty close to those figures, 33% on one side and I think 66% on the other side. I was looking at it, and it looked like the high side was maybe 15 to 20% longer than the low side after it was all said and done, you know. And so those two figures kind of work out. So I guess it's close to a Wyndham, Roger.
Yeah, it's doing a great job for you there, Jim, yeah. Yeah, it's about nice to experiment with antennas, different ones. I've just always used resonant dipoles here, or inverted Vs in the case of 160. That's center-fed with the coax. Not even using any kind of a balanced line, although I have tuners here that will accept balanced line. I just find it easier to run coax. All my antennas are resonant here, Jim. I have got a 160 meter half wave inverted V, and then I have dipoles for 80, 60, and 40 meters. And then I have a Mosley PE33 beam up for 2015 and 10. So got a lot of wire, a lot of coax, and makes things easier to tune up and all that. Well, yeah, the station here, I'm running a Yaesu FT2000, the Yaesu FT2000, driving an amplifier, Kenwood, the Kenwood TL922A, about 700-800 watts. I do have an SP221 also, Jim. That's my amplifier for 20 meters. I have two stations here right now, this one, and then I have a Yaesu 1000 MP Mark V, and I drive the heat kit, the SP220 or 221, same thing, the amplifier, and I can run that at about a kilowatt on 20 meters, so that's pretty much dedicated to 20. I don't switch off of that station for anything else, so that's the only one. But I just looked on your QRZ page, Jim. I guess you've video. Your two things are happening to get on your Jim Ferguson's radio story, your QSO vlog, and I'm seeing like many QSOs you've had here. Did you video or record all your QSOs or just?
We usually record a couple of times a week, about an hour or two each time. Come up with about 5 to 10 QSOs, each time, and then bust them up and post them up on YouTube so folks can hear what they really sound like. A lot of those air checks on YouTube are folks with recording it on their camera microphone, so it turns out that the QSO sounds more like the guy's room than what it actually does. So all of our stuff we take direct and pay particular attention to the front end AGC circuit to make sure we stay out of AGC compression so we can record as near a perfect signal, a real signal as possible. Roger.
Oh, very good. Yeah, I was listening to some of the ones you taped there. They sound pretty good. What camera are you using to record those?
This is a USB camera. We're recording direct through the computer, Roger. And so obviously with a kilowatt next door, it has been a trying experience to render the ambient RF out of the video audio. But at the moment we are succeeding, Roger.
Yeah, very good, very good. Yeah, I had a little camera that I hooked up to, I don't know if you ever got on Skype before, but we used to get on Skype with the video. I had this little camera, USB camera, and I plugged that into my I was using a laptop at the time, and it was a pretty good video. Have you ever used Skype video before?
I was going to at one time when we first started. I thought it might be neat, and I was working on getting an interview, a Skype interview, with one individual that everybody knows, but really became a pain. a real pain. It was always one thing after the other about why they couldn't do it, and so I just gave up on Skype. I mean, the video is not the thing anyway. My main thing is audio, so the video is just there to satisfy YouTube. A talking head to satisfy YouTube. That's all that is. The audio is the main thing, Roger.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, very good. Very good. Yeah, it works out pretty good. Like I said, the audio sounds good on the on there. Now this computer I'm listening to it on. I don't have the outboard speakers hooked on. I have another computer over here. I have a Flex 5000A hooked into it, and I have a real nice outboard speaker system. So the speakers on these monitors here aren't good at all, as you know, not very good at all, and you don't get a really good representation of the audio quality. Now, when I go to my other computer there with the outboard speaker systems, boy, what a big difference! It has a little subwoofer on it and a couple other speakers, and in fact, the bass is even adjustable on that. A real good set of computer speakers really goes a long way for sure. The ones in these monitors are pretty lousy, actually. So I've got think I got a couple of computers with the outboard speakers systems on them, and I prefer that one. I was going to pull one. I do have another speaker system I was going to put on this one. I have that upstairs, and I think maybe at some point in time I just might do that. But yeah, that's kind of neat there, Jim. That's the first time I've seen, you know, you got something going there, and it's the first time I've seen anyone with the videos there, you know, like you have on there. KC9VKV, WA3GPE.
Roger, Roger, Glenn. Well, it's, you know, we started about a year and a half ago. Oh, that's interesting. My computer just came up after 20 minutes of loading. I wonder what's wrong with that picture. Anyway, yeah, about a year and a half ago, I think we started the QSO Vlog segments. And, you know, we've come along. I think we're about 160 or 165 now. And we've made... you know, all different kinds of changes to our QSO Vlog studio, so to speak, adding things. It's kind of like a Noah's Ark now of parts and pieces that occupy the screen. Like I say, the video is just to get there, you know. Everything YouTube does is video, so, you know, we just use that as a medium to get our audio up there. And, you know, we run, like I say, probably about 10 to 15 QSOs a week, or have been anyway, and trying to get them all chopped up in their various segments. Occasionally, if conditions are great, we'll just let the video track, and we'll just run the... you know, run the QSOs back to back there, maybe an hour or so, and then post them all together there. Just put the call signs up in sequence so everybody can find out you know where they are. Roger.
Yeah, very good there, Jim. Yeah, that's interesting. I was just kind of scrolling down to the ones you have here, and I recognize some of the call signs of some of the guys that you have here on your YouTube thing here. I've worked some of those guys before, some familiar call signs. There was another thing that I was talking to some guys up on 160 one time, and they have I think it's called Live Chat or something. It's a website, okay? It's a website, and they've got their cameras on their station, but you know, and they've got their audio streaming through, so I could actually get on their website and see them transmitting, and also, you know, when they turn it over to me, I can hear myself and see my signal transmitting through their station. And I think it's, I'm trying to remember that website there, Live Chat or something like that, but there's a lot of that on there. It's just amazing the stuff you find on the internet. Of course, they've got these receiver sites. They have one in eastern Pennsylvania. A guy has a receiver site, and you can get on there. And a lot of guys actually get on some of these remote receiver sites to hear signals that maybe they might not hear. So there's a lot of things going on there, but. Yeah, that's quite interesting. I wonder if you ever heard of that Live Chat. I don't know if that's the name of it or not, but it's a live feed. KC9DKV, WA3GPE.
Roger, Glenn, I have heard of it. I haven't checked it out at all, though, you know. But it sounds like a neat thing. I think anything that adds a new twist to amateur radio, keeps it fresh and new and interesting, I think it's great, you know. I'm trying to do my part, you know, with the QSO Vlog, so, you know, guys can check out their signals, and there's nothing harder than to actually hear your own station. That's one of the hardest things to do, and our QSO Vlogs gives them the chance to do that. Your signal is kind of fluctuating. Sometimes at its best, you're about... I'm looking at the output of the audio from the 990, looking at the VU meter watching the output of the 990, and from times you are 8 dB above the noise level, and then sometimes, you know, it's faded right into the noise level, so there is, you know, the noise level and you are the same, but mostly you're above that and averaging probably about maybe 5 dB above noise level, as would show up on a VU meter.
Yeah, very good there, Jim. Yeah, your signal's hanging in there. I don't really notice a whole lot of fading on your signal, so it's hanging in there very good. But the band conditions have been really terrible. And sometimes I tune around on 40 here. I don't usually hear anything. You know, a lot of strong signals at all. When I'm running my flex, of course, I have the band scope, you know, the waterfall. And at times I look on there, I look at any signals in 30, 20, 30, 40 kcs, and the signal may pop up here and there. I kind of look at that band scope on this radio here. It's been pretty bad, actually. I just don't know. Looked at some of the predictions, and, I can't see why the conditions are as bad as they have been here, but that's just the way it goes here. You know, sometimes you just have to take what you get, and that's why I've usually been working on 20, because I've always been able to get some contact on 20. But lately, it just doesn't hear a whole lot going on there. So,
did you work any of the other
bands
here, Jim?
I missed just the end of that, Glenn. Conditions are kind of bouncing in and out. So let's see. I just did something. I'm going to try to reverse that. Hang on just a moment. There we go. I'm a lot better. Not sure, but those conditions, the last transmission kind of faded out right at the end. So let me pass along threes right now, Glenn, as long as I got it there, and maybe later on the conditions might improve a little bit. But I think we got a little bit to work with here that we'll post up on YouTube. So again, if you go to YouTube and do a call letter search, Kilo Charlie 9 Victor Kilo Victor, that will take you to our QSO Vlog page. Right at the top of the page, there's one that has about 165 QSOs in it. And if you click on that, our QSO should be right there just below Art Bell. Roger.
Yeah, okay there, Jimmy. I'm on that right now. Yeah, it says 169 videos you got on there. And I see the video there. Okay, yeah.
Roger, roger, threes out of the way. Have a good day. This is Kilo Charlie 9, Victor, Kilo Victor, threes.